So, in this video, I wanted to discuss something that's been on my mind for a while, and I'm sure that you have thought about it. And that is, what is Nintendo going to do to the 3DS? Because even Nintendo said themselves, like, they don't know the future of the 3DS, because now the Switch is out, there's no real point to the 3DS. So, why would they keep supporting it? And that left a lot of people scratching their heads. I mean, although the 3DS is, in my opinion, a great console, nobody really knows, including Nintendo, the future of the console. So, in this video, I just wanted to take some time to talk about my personal memories with the 3DS and what I think Nintendo is going to do with it. But before I get into my main thoughts on this, something I have to make sure that you are very clear on is that this is an opinionated video, and if you have your own thoughts on this, I would highly recommend that you left those thoughts in the comments. And since my channel is so small, I'll try to reply back to you. But that's not what's important, so let's just keep going. So, when I buy a game console, I usually look for what's innovative about it and what makes it powerful. So, with the Nintendo Switch, when I bought it, what I was looking at it for was that I saw Skyrim and I saw other games I really loved, and like, those games I really wanted to play on the go, and that's why I wanted to get it. But at the same time, the games looked great on the Switch, so that's why I picked it up. That's the main reason why I picked it up. It wasn't for, I mean, I did want to play Breath of the Wild, but it did on a Wii U, so if I just wanted to play Breath of the Wild, I could just literally play it on my Wii U. But I picked up the Switch version of it, and I've been happy with that ever since. But the 3DS was a different case. The 3DS, when I bought it, I didn't know what to expect. Now, I've owned a 3DS once in my life. I don't know when, but all I know is that I broke it at some time. And I got a new 3DS XL, literally had this habit of buying things literally pretty much just a day before the successor comes out. And the irony is incredible. But still, like, I bought the 3DS, like my new one, in 2015 because I thought I would really like it. But my main overview to it was that it had its own, like, feeling to it. It's not, I loved my 3DS, but it wasn't what I expected. I expected it to just be a generic portable game console, but what it was something a whole lot more. It had its own special kind of charm to it. I'm sure that you know, like, when you get a game console or something like that, it has its own charm to it that can't be matched by any other console. So, that's what I loved about the 3DS. But as time went on, I picked up more and more games for it, and what I noticed is that charm started to mold into different things. Like, when I picked up one of my favorite games for the 3DS, is Sun and Moon. I love that game, but it had a different charm than the 3DS came with. It's a very weird thing to think about, but I wanted to bring it up because it correlates into my thoughts on Nintendo on the future of the 3DS. And here's what I think Nintendo is going to do. So, like I said, I love my 3DS to bits, but I think Nintendo knows that the 3DS is on its way out. So, the 3DS came out in 2011. It's now 2018. So the 3DS has had so far a solid 7 years. And in the last Nintendo Direct, they showed a game for 3DS that would be coming out in 2019. So we know the 3DS will at least still receive, like, official game support. I think it was a third-party game. But we know that the 3DS is at least going to, like, keep getting a bit of attention from Nintendo into 2019. But what I think Nintendo's going to do is they're going to release Detective Pikachu, and then what they're going to do is they're going to do what they did with the Wii U. Now, what Nintendo did with the Wii U is they gave it its, like, a final voyage. Nintendo sent the Wii U on its final voyage at the end of 2016. And that final voyage, I can't speak today, was a bundle that came with Smash and Mario Kart 8. I think that's what it came with. And I think that's what Nintendo is going to do with the 3DS. They're going to bundle it up with some of the 3DS's best games, whether that be Smash for 3DS, Mario Maker for 3DS, that kind of stuff. The best games, Sun and Moon, X and Y, all of that, maybe two or three of them, and put them on a single 3DS bundle. Probably going to be a 2DS XL, to be honest, but I have no idea. And they're going to put it like that. Maybe it'll be all 3DSs, but they're going to put it on in that little bundle box, and they're going to ship it out, and then after that, maybe after the bundle's been on sale for like 2 months, I think that's when Nintendo's going to cut the cord. I think after that, Nintendo's not going to completely remove the 3DS, but I think they're going to discontinue it, which, if you don't know somehow what discontinue means, it means to cease production. Nintendo will no longer be making 3DSs, and I'm assuming that's going to apply to both the 2DS XL, the 2DS, the 3DS, the 3DS XL, the new 3DS XL, all of those consoles, all the versions of 3DS and 2DS will be gone. And I then think what Nintendo's going to do is they're going to, I hate saying this because it just destroys me to talk about this because I love my 3DS as much as someone can. But I think what they're going to do is they're going to stop releasing official games. I think Detective Pikachu, I have a feeling it's not going to be the last official game from Nintendo, but I think it's going to be one of the last few. I think the last one's going to be something that'll hit the 3DS out of the park, and then it's done. Now, if I were to take a guess as to when Nintendo's going to cut the cord on the 3DS, I would say later 2018, maybe at the latest early, like very early 2019, because at that point, the Switch will almost be 2 years old. So Nintendo, they've already phased into the Switch, and something that Nintendo hasn't done with their consoles is with the 3DS is that once their successor comes out, they cut the cord on the previous one. That's what they did with the Wii U, but they haven't done it to the Switch yet. Or not the Switch, the 3DS. So I think Nintendo's going to give, because the Switch is technically a successor to the 3DS, so I think Nintendo's going to give the 3DS enough time to die down, and then once the time is right, I hate saying this, but I have to, I think the 3DS will flatline. So that's really sad to think about, because like I said, I've had so many great memories with my 3DS, but like with any console, like, change is just part of the process. Eventually, you gotta move on. So after that, I think what Nintendo's going to do is they're going to completely focus on the Switch. I think Wii U support at that point, like, I think Nintendo's just gonna, like, completely flatten out the Wii U and then do the same to the 3DS eventually. And then they're just gonna put all their eggs into one basket and focus on the Switch. And I think the Switch is going to last, like Nintendo said, they see it lasting past the typical 5 years. And I think Nintendo's just going to be their future, their next decade of Nintendo is just going to be on the Switch. Unfortunately, what that means for a 3DS is that probably soon we're going to see the 3DS be completely phased out. And by completely phased out, I mean no support, no online, no eShop, none of that. So it's really hard to say these things because A, like I keep saying, I love my 3DS, and B, the 3DS, I feel like it still has a bit of a future left for it, and I don't work at Nintendo, and I can't really say anything, but you have no idea. Like, these are all just predictions of what I think Nintendo's going to do. I hope, in a perfect world, what Nintendo would do is they would keep the 3DS on life support long enough for, like, everyone on the 3DS bandwagon to transition to the Switch. But you know that's not what they're going to do. They're going to have to focus on the Switch. And that means that the 3DS is probably without a future. So that's what I think, but I would love to hear your thoughts on this in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, then I would appreciate it if you shared this video on social media. And if you like this video as well, you can, well, like the video. And if you want to be updated of when I upload new content, then I would highly recommend you do so, because that supports me as well. Again, I hope you did enjoy this video, and see you.